What do we know about today's mutual fund owner? ICI's most recent survey of mutual fund owning households is out. It takes a look at their age, their goals, even how they invest. Here's the latest from ICI's Senior Director of Retirement Investor Research, Sarah Holden.
So the most recent survey was done this summer, and we find that 44% of U.S. households, or about 56 million U.S. households, own mutual funds.
So Sarah, what's exciting about that is that then we can look at generations. Do you see certain patterns from generation to generation?
And what we see there is a pattern of ownership that makes sense when you think about where these households are in their life cycle. So about half of Gen X and baby boom households own mutual funds. So these are folks who have been in their careers for a bit, are saving for retirement, have been introduced to investing. When we look at younger households, like millennial households, fewer of them are engaged in mutual fund ownership, but remarkably, almost 4 in 10 of them already own mutual funds. They're at an early stage of their life cycle. They're young, they're starting families, they're just starting their career, so they're just getting introduced to investing. When we then step back and take a look at the mutual fund households themselves, we see that a little over a third of them are baby boom households, and a little less than a third of them are Gen X. And because those baby boomers have been saving and investing longer, they actually own the lion's share of mutual fund assets held by households. They hold 45% of them. And they're the folks that are, you know, entering retirement and starting to rebalance and think about, you know, spending those funds.
So that's their nest egg naturally, mm-hmm. from kind of a lifetime of savings at this point.
Yes, and so that's why they are a big base in our shareholder base.
So what do we learn about the types of funds that these various mutual fund investors hold?
Mutual fund investors come to own funds through a variety of channels, and that impacts the type of funds that they own. 8 in 10 of them own funds through a retirement plan at work, so like a defined contribution plan such as a 401k plan. 63% of them have purchased funds outside of those workplace plans. It could be through an IRA, or it could just be through a brokerage account or something like that. So many different ways to come at owning funds, and indeed about half of them use an investment professional, so they'll talk to a broker or a financial advisor to figure out which funds to buy. About a third of them just say, I'm going to figure it out myself, and they go directly to a fund website or through a discount broker. About 9 in 10 of them own equity funds, which lines up with sort of their long-term views in terms of investing.
So now that we know more about mutual fund investors in terms of who they are, how old they are, and how they've come to owning funds, what do we know about their goals?
Not surprisingly, we know that more than half of long-term mutual fund assets are held in defined contribution plan accounts or IRAs. And so when we talk to households that actually own mutual funds, it's not surprising that they say saving for retirement is important. 93% of them say that it's one of their financial goals, and almost 3/4 of them say it's actually their primary goal for their mutual fund investments. But folks do have other reasons for saving and investing. Almost half say that they're saving for an emergency, just to have some money on hand, and about 1/4 say education is one of their financial goals.
And Sarah, as ever, all of this treasure trove of information is online.
Yes, all of the reports are posted on our website.